Okay, what's going on, guys? So down at Engine Room Gym, and today is officially the first day of my cut for the Arnold. Starting off with leg day down here, we're focused on a lot of heavy movements, a lot of compound movements. So starting off with some squats. I'm gonna take you guys through today's leg session and basically go into more detail about what I do and the reasons why I do it. Gonna be starting off with a few warm-up sets, so just doing it with the bar, then I'll go up to 60 kg, probably 100 kg, and see where we go from there. Yeah, so training on my own today and going for like heavy squats and stuff. So if there's a time where you're gonna see me like shit myself or die, this is gonna be that time. So keep a close eye on this video. Right, so the idea of these sets is just to warm up and get the blood flowing. It's not to actually exhaust myself, so I'm only doing like 10, 12 reps. You also see that we're back in the last set of 60 kg. Is a lot straighter than what it was in the first original set. That's because I slightly adjusted my stance after watching the footage back. And this is how I got into video recording my workouts in the first place, is that I used to use the camera to actually check my form. And I still do that now, even though I'm recording for you guys, I'll still watch it back and double check that I'm doing everything correctly. So remember, form over weight. Okay, three plates, first working set. Okay, stuck a bit more weight on, going for about 8 reps or so, let's do what we do. For the growth, it's all about eating and overload, so trying to get the weight up as high as possible. Okay, so it's now genuinely about an inch away, or like one rep away from shit myself. So one more set on these four plates, and then we can drop the weight down and do another two or three back off sets, which are gonna be more focused on volume, then probably gonna go into leg press. No sleep, no sleep, no sleep. Trying to do my thing, but you always got me in too deep. Can't breathe, can't breathe, can't breathe. You keep making faces that I don't wanna see. Okay, so that's me done for the squats for now. Moving on to some leg press on the most dodgy leg press machine you're ever gonna see. Literally looks like it's made in like a backyard or something. But hope you won't die. Okay, putting the feet quite low down. Fairly close together, really isolating the quads. It will mean you probably won't be able to lift that as much as if you're doing normal leg press with your feet a little bit higher. But yeah, you're focusing your quads, and that is what this session is for. But yeah, so higher volume on these if we're getting heavy on the squats. Go for like 12, 15 reps, hit 15 on this. Weight's going up. definitely not going to be walking tomorrow. Okay, this ain't gonna be pretty, but let's have a look what faces you should be pulling when you're doing leg press. Up next is single leg extensions. Isolation exercise after we've been doing two big compound movements. Also with leg extensions, it's really, really important, just like most exercises or any exercise, in fact, to really be able to feel the contraction. If you're just swinging your legs up and down consistently, yeah, you're doing the exercise, but you're not gonna get the contraction, you're not gonna build the same muscles as someone who is actually feeling the contraction, doing it slowly and doing the exercise correctly. Okay, so my camera is on like super low battery, I haven't got any batteries with me at the minute, so I'm gonna have to make things snappy for the rest of it. Basically, I've done three sets of single leg, so three sets of each leg, and now moving on to another two or three sets of doing leg extensions with both legs. Fucking exhausted. After this, we can go on to some lunges. Hopefully, we'll be able to get some footage of that as well to show you guys. Okay, so one of the big asks I get from you guys is, what do I do for abs? So I'm gonna kind of show you at the end of this. Funny enough, I don't actually have a set ab routine. I can do abs from once a week, twice a week, all the way up to like five times a week, depending on kind of what I feel like, what my body feels like. If my core is feeling really, really weak from doing a lot of squats and stuff, I'll probably reduce the amount of ab training I do in a week. However, if I'm feeling good, like I am at the minute, feeling strong, might do three or four training sessions which include abs per week. So I'm going to show you in a minute what I actually do for abs. I just train them at the end of each session, or end of the session if I'm going to do them, and it's basically just doing like a quick circuit, smash them really hard, and that's it. Okay, so as you guys probably guessed, my camera did end up dying just after I filmed some of my ab stuff, but I hope you guys have kind of enjoyed the video. If there's anything you guys want to see, just let me know in the comments down below, and I'll try and get a video done of it. I'm gonna try and be uploading two videos a week now. One's gonna be following my prep for the Arnolds, and the other one's gonna be of your guys choosing. So just let me know what you want to see and I will produce it. But yeah, obviously leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe if you're new, and yeah, I really appreciate all the support you guys are giving, so keep giving it. And I'll be producing more and more content. Obviously, the more support I get, the more stuff I can produce. But yeah, thank you again, and I'll see you guys in the next video.